We're in Khabarovsk today and we're going to talk about Amur, one of the most popular teams in the league. Selling hockey tickets is not a problem around here. Win or lose, Amur home games are always sold out. For the home opener last season, tickets were sold out in just half an hour. Not only was it a home opener, but it was against Admiral, Amur's greatest rival. Moreover, it was a rivalry between the two coaches, Evgeny Papikhin and Hannu Yortika. The latter coached Amur before he joined Admiral, and local fans loved him dearly. Today he came to Khabarovsk as Admiral's coach, but Amur fans still love him. We were really happy to see him back here. He's very respected by Khabarovsk fans. It was good to see him back here. It would have been even better if we could beat Admiral, though. I really don't care who's the coach, Papikhin or Yortika. The only thing that matters to me is the team. We respect every coach in the league, but we live in the present, not the past. We're looking forward to this season. We just need to find our rhythm, and everything will be okay. Evgeny Papikhin has a different coaching approach compared to Yortika's. He's much less authoritarian on the bench. So far, it didn't lead to great accomplishments in hockey, though. Say what you want about a coaching job, but the most important thing for a coach is to find his team and join it at the right time, says Papikhin. Amur was Papikhin's fifth club in the KHL. It was really important for him to do well this year because he was the one who built this team. Amur looked good in the preseason, winning a few tournaments, but unfortunately, things didn't work out for them in the regular season, and the team is going to have a new coach next year again. When your team is not winning enough games, it is very important to stay calm. No matter what they say about you, you have to stay calm and work hard. The second you start to second-think yourself, is going to be your end. Did Amur get any better last season than the season before? One thing you can say for sure is that they had a better roster on their hands. Judging by the names on the list, they could give any KHL team a run for their money. One of the best signings for them was Calder Cup champion Jan Mursak. Slovenian forward started the season well and later on went on to join Red Army. He had something to prove to the Detroit Red Wings, where he didn't get a lot of chances. Mursak believes he's going to be in the KHL for a while. The skill level of players here is good, he says. There's a lot of skating. That's what I like. I like playing against top clubs most. I'm not very used to play at center, but I'm doing okay. Hopefully that's going to help me to get a lot of points and help my team. A season before that, Mursak did get a lot of points in the AHL and won the Calder Cup with the Grand Rapids Griffins. It was nice to play so long and win a cup in the end. It was a great way to say my goodbyes to North America. I had a great time in the USA. Hopefully it's going to be as much fun for me in Russia. In the KHL, Mursak took number 13. In Grand Rapids, he wore number 39, even though he always wanted to wear 13. One of the other key figures for Amur this season was goal Alexei Murygin. At times he made incredible saves to give his team a chance to win. His partner in goal was Finnish netminder Mika Järvinen. They split the season half and half. Amur applied the same strategy when Murygin played alongside with Jan Lašak. Järvinen had an okay debut season in the KHL and at times looked much better than Murygin, even though Järvinen is one of the shortest goalies in the league at 5'10". I'm not the tallest guy, but I'm trying to compensate that with my agility, he says. I move around the crease a lot, and I'm very effective with my glove and blocker. I don't think I belong to a certain style. I try to do a little bit of everything. My job is to stop the puck. Last season, import players felt a little more comfortable at Amur because of the new conditioning coach, a Canadian, Spero Mantzavrakas. He introduced the players to some unusual exercises that should help them play more aggressive and physical hockey. He introduced Amur to a special diet and a special set of exercises. With him, recovering became an essential part of practices. Unfortunately, the system didn't help Amur much, and his contract was not renewed. Papichin's assistant this season was Alexander Smirnov. He's a coach with decent experience. His most notable work was done with Severstal, where he worked with Dmitry Kvartanov. Smirnov felt at home in Khabarovsk right away. It's a good team, a blue-collar team, he says. We got our points because of our discipline and work ethic. We didn't have a lot of stars, but we had a good team. We had a new team, so we had new players and new line combinations, says forward Evgeny Orlov. We had a lot of motivation and tried to win every game. No matter how well Amur does in the KHL, the atmosphere in the dressing room is always great. It's very cozy in here. There's a lot of jokes and smiling around. Like this time when they interviewed each other for one of the local TV networks.
Mika, what do you feel like? First team picture. Feel part of the team?
Excited, you know.
Yeah, I can feel the vibe though.
Oh, yeah. Don't know what to expect.
Did you make up your hair? Or?
Yeah, a little bit, of course.
Yeah, you look good though.
Oh, thanks, man.
Видите, какой настрой? Это всего лишь второй матч и между собой. Вот наш новый тренер. Добро пожаловать.
Здравствуйте. Хорошая погода.
Отличное настроение, да.
Отличное настроение рабочее, да.
Самое время поиграть в хоккей, так что.
Вперед.
Вперед из песни.
Amur does a lot of various activities for the fans. Last summer, they even took part in the beautification project. The entire team, along with the head coach, went out to pick up trash at the banks of Amur River.
И там чисто, где убирают, а там, где не ссорят. Поэтому желание,
да, конечно,
кто сюда приезжает.
Fans are really important to Amur. At least twice a season they meet them outside of the rink. Table hockey and air hockey tournaments became a tradition in Khabarovsk.
Турниры по настольному или аэрохоккею – добрая традиция.
This time the fans lost the tournament to Amur players, but it was a very close battle. Although the fans didn't get upset much. Some of them saw this outcome as a good sign. Hopefully they can take this winning spirit onto the ice as well. Despite all of that, Amur missed the playoffs again and didn't do well at the Nadezhda Cup either. This season is going to be once again a new team, but their fans expect a different outcome.